Gracias.
Gracias a todos. Hay personas que no entienden inglés. Bien, si hablo inglés. Ok, bueno. So, I'm Robert Murray. Do I need the microphone? Are we okay? I do need it? Oh, okay. I'll use the microphone then. I can talk a little calmer then. So that was the Rossini Overture. Today's program, we have quite a range of music from this all the way up to the 20th century, but it's very easy 20th century, I'll warn you. So the next piece we're going to do is a Schubert Unfinished Symphony. Nobody really knows why he didn't finish it, but it actually never got premiered or played for about 40 years after his death. It's one of those strange things about composers. They don't really often get discovered before they die. And he was a composer of about 600, 700 lieder, which are pieces for piano and voice. That was his most famous works. But for me, the following piece is very important.
And I'll tell you why. The first time I held a baton in front of an orchestra, I was 13 years old. And this is the piece that I first performed. So for me, this is going back, and this is the first time I've been with this orchestra for the season, so it's sort of, there's a little synchronicity there. But this piece is, some people consider it the first romantic symphony. Although it was written during Beethoven's time, it is so different from Beethoven, as you'll hear later, that it's quite amazing the tonality and the sounds that he gets out of the orchestra with this piece. Many people sort of wonder about classical music. I know so many of you are patrons of ProMusica, but really, especially in this case, enjoy the journey. Like, listen to the music and just imagine how it's progressing and what's going on, and you'll hear the same theme played many times, but different every time. And just follow that journey along emotionally, whether it's pictures in your mind as to what's going on, it's your own story. And that's what makes this classical music so incredible, is that you can make it your own personal story as to how it proceeds. So without further ado, this is Schubert's Unfinished.
Can we have a quick A?
Thank you. Thank you. Here we go.
Come on, vamos. Pasado.
Thank you very much. So that wasn't so bad for Shostakovich, was it? No. Okay, good, good. I told you it wouldn't be a tough 20th century piece. I have to talk a little bit about the next piece you're going to hear. Many of you have heard me say about Beethoven. People ask me, who is the greatest composer of all time? And it's very difficult to say because they're all geniuses. In my opinion, Beethoven was the greatest because he had the most influence. If you can imagine, for 100 years after Beethoven, composers didn't know what to do. They lived under this cloud, like Beethoven already did it. All of his symphonies were different, and they formed different rivers in time through the 19th century, different types of music, and it was all because of Beethoven that he started these things. The Schubert that we heard couldn't have been done that way without the influence of Beethoven starting that type of music. So I don't want to go into all those little details, but I'm going to tell you something about this next piece because it's Beethoven's first symphony. And he basically says, I have arrived. And it's fascinating how he does that. Audiences in those times actually understood music harmony. They knew what key things were in. They knew the different pitches and what was going on. The education, in 1865 in Cambridge University, they finally stopped making music mandatory because there was too much to learn to become a doctor or get your doctorate. So they finally stopped making music mandatory. Up until then, everybody in university was a very proficient musician. Very interesting how times have changed, eh? You know, really remarkable. So the very first note you hear in this symphony shocked audiences. They went, oh my God, that's wrong. You can't start a symphony that way. And I'm going to just try to show you how that's done.
The ultima note in este movimento. Con un blanco.
So that's the tone that they're expecting to hear, okay? This is what Beethoven does.
Primero.
See, it's the same. Now the audience goes, oh my God, how can he do that? He can't do that. So that's the experience that it happened. And he continues to go further and further away from what's considered the tonic, which is your root, that's like home. So he starts the symphony not at home, but by going somewhere strange. And that's his way of saying, I have arrived. Okay. Now the second movement. You know, back in, if you listen to Haydn and Mozart, they have a slow movement. And the other movement that they have is, it's a dance, it's a minuet, and that's a waltz. And it's a very elegant waltz. And you can see them dancing, 2-3-1, 2-3-1, 2. That's a waltz. So what does Beethoven do? He makes the second movement sound like a waltz. Sounds like a minuet. But he uses stuff from Bach. And he changes it suddenly to become a fugue. Like bringing in things. The audience is sitting here thinking, this is supposed to be a minuet, but it's not a minuet. I don't know what this is. So he actually, like, he vaults us into some other stratosphere with that second movement. And it's very interesting because it sounds very much like a minuet, but it's the slow movement and it's done differently. Now, the third, he calls minuet. Now, if you listen to those symphonies of Haydn and Mozart, what they have as minuets are these nice little dances. They're very easy to play for the orchestra. Actually, they're very simple, and they have a particular form. Well, Beethoven does that, except he accelerates it to the point of the most difficult piece in the whole, the most difficult movement in the whole piece. And it's fast, and in full of fire, completely different. Again, he gives us a big contrast. And then he ends in a very Beethoven fashion with the fourth movement, with a bit of a surprise, but at the same time, it sounds like standard classical music, and you can contrast this to the Schubert that you heard earlier, because it's very, very classical, okay? So enjoy Beethoven's one, and I wish that you could experience it for the first time the way the audiences did 200 years ago, because I must say that must have been just shocking to them. Thank you.
We need to tune. Yes, we have to, especially for this. And different classes, so just the woodwinds first, and then the bronzes. And if we have to, it has to be moved.
While they tune, I'll just tell you, it's very difficult outside. The instruments go out of tune within minutes in this kind of heat and the wind. So we need to take that extra time to tune. So, and I'm going to be quiet because it stops them from tuning properly. So just so that you know.
Thank you.
did the same thing.
There's no going back.
It was an extra thing. You're okay? You're managed.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for coming, and what a wonderful season we've had. And thank you ProMusica and all of the patrons for all of your support. These students are coming from 5 different cities. Many of them are traveling 4 hours for every Sunday rehearsal of 3 hours. It's a lot of work. They put in the effort, and I think it's sounding excellent. I'm very, very proud of these youngsters. So, well done.